everyone. I, Aarti Bajaj from MCA department in Technia Institute of Advanced Studies. Today, I am going to deliver a lecture on the basic concepts of relational model and its characteristics. Let's discuss one by one. The first is relation. Informally, a relation looks like a table of values. A relation typically contains a set of rows. The data element in each row represent certain facts that correspond to a real-world entity or the relationship. In the formal model, rows are called tuples. On the other hand, each column has a column header that gives an indication of the meaning of the data item in that column. In the formal model, the column header is called attribute name or the attribute. Here is an example of the relation. Next is keys. Each row has a value of a data item that uniquely identifies that row in a table. That is called a key. In the student table, like SSN is a key. Sometimes row ID or the sequential numbers are assigned as the key to identify the row in a table called the artificial key or the surrogate key. Each row has one or more attributes known as the relation key, which can identify the row in a relation uniquely. Next concept is relation instance. A finite set of tuples in the relational database system represent the relation instance. Relation instance do not have duplicate tuples. Next is relation schema. A relation schema describes the relation name, like the table name, attributes and their names. The schema denoted by the R of A1, A2, A3 up to AN, where A1, A2, A3 and AN are the attributes and R is the name of the relation. For example, if we want to create a relation of the customer, we must have the attributes like customer ID, customer name, address and the phone number, where customer is the relation name which defined over the four attributes like the cust ID, cust name, address and the phone number. Each attribute has a domain or the set of valid values. For example, the domain of the cust ID is 6-digit number that contains the valid value. A tuple is an ordered set of values which enclosed in the angular brackets and the each value is derived from an appropriate domain. A row in the customer relation is a 4-tuple and would consist of 4 values. That's why it is called a 4-tuple as it has 4 values. So these are the basic concepts of a relational model. Next, discuss the characteristics of a relation. First is ordering of tuple in a relation R. The tuples are not considered to be ordered even though they appear to be in the tabular form. Second is ordering of attributes in a relation schema R and of values within each tuple. We will consider the attributes in R relation as A1, A2, A3 and AN and the values in the tuple as V1, V2, V3 up to the VN which to be ordered. Third characteristic is values in a table. All values are considered to be atomic. Each value in a tuple must be from the domain of the attribute for that column. If tuple T having the values V1, V2 up to the Vn is a particular tuple in the relation state R of the relation R having attributes A1, A2, A3 up to the An, then each VI must have a value from the domain AI. A special null value is used to represent the values that are unknown or inapplicable to certain tuples. Next characteristic is notation. We refer to the component values of a tuple T by T of AI or T dot AI. This is the value VI of the attribute AI for the tuple T. Similarly, we have the T of A1, 2, 3 up to the AN, which refer to a subtuple of the T containing the values of the attribute as A1 to AN respectively in a particular tuple. So, we must follow all the characteristics of a relational model if we want to create a specific relational model. So, that's all about the topic, the relational model basic concepts and the characteristics of the relational model. I hope you understand the topic. Thank you very much. And if you want to view more videos related to this topic, subscribe Technia TV. Thank you.